If the sun comes up without me tomorrow, if I leave this world tonight, would you really know how much I care about you or the way you've changed my life? I know there would be tears, and I hope you'd get past them. And when you think of me, you'll think of me laughing. Go on living, don't stop loving. Please find something you can put your heart into. And if the sun comes up without me tomorrow, you'll be fine. Just let it shine on you. If the sun comes up and I'm not there to hold you, don't you let it cloud your faith. Never lose your smile and hold on to your passion and make the world a place. I know you won't forget the life we have together, and more than anything, I hope you'll remember to go on living, don't stop loving. Please find something you can put your heart in. The sun comes up without me tomorrow, you'll be fine. Just let it shine on you. I believe you'll watch the sunrise with me for years to come. But if it turns out this morning, our last one, baby, go on living, don't stop loving. Please find something you can put your heart into.
I was the first to finish four or five. No foe shall challenge our right to victory and take the field a grandson to see. Pride of the infantry, men of a great division, courage is our tradition. Forward the big red one. Go ordinance.
In the rain blowing in my face, and the whole world's on the gaze, I would offer you a warning grace to make you feel mine. Evening shadows and the stars. There is no one to ride. I could hold you for a million years to make you feel. No, you haven't made your mind, but I would never. in that room. There's no doubt in my mind where you belong. I'd go hungry, I'd go black, I'd go crawling down the aisle. There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love. Storms are raging on a rolling sea, down the highway of regret. The winds of change are blowing wild and free, but you ain't seen nothing like me yet. There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do, go to the ends of the earth for you, make you happy, make your dreams come true, to make you feel my love. Thank you. sacrifice. Give it everything you got, and you won't think twice. You risk it all, no matter what may come. When you love someone,
chances are you'll find me somewhere on your road tonight. Seems I always end up driving by. Ever since I've known you, it just seems you're on my way. All the rules of logic don't apply. To see you in the night, be with you till morning light.
I remember clearly how you looked the night we met. I recall your laughter and your smile.
Try to steal who you are. Years of pain fall from your face as you run like a child to his embrace. Breathe in, breathe in.
And come broken hearted, all you who wander, behold the love of the unfailing Father.
Mighty God, fountain of all life, our refuge and strength and our help in trouble, we know the concerns of the hearts of all gathered here. Give to us now your grace as we remember John L. Locicero. Enable us, we pray, to put our trust in you and find grace to help in this and every time gathered. Let us consider John's life and his love and the happiness that he often brought to others. I truly believe that God will see, hear, and feel our thankfulness for John as we remember his life. And we can rest assured knowing that the Holy Spirit will be with us during the service, and that Jesus accepts all who believe in him and is prepared especially for them.
Mark, I am really prepared for this, so bear with me. When I think of John Locicero, I think open doors. I think coming in early in the morning to go to work and his office door being wide open. There's always an inviting place somewhere I could sit down with him, just, you know, pardon my language, just shoot the shit. And we could talk about from family, and his family, my family, to work and our soldiers that we were working with. I think of the open doors he gave me into his home to let me in to his family. I've never been too close to a whole lot of families, but he was always very inviting. His face is going down, their children. He was a leader in the sense that he would look at you, see where your flaws were, and then he would look at himself and see, well, do I have that? Well, let me lead from the front. I'm going to change myself before I tell you to fix yourself. He was always trying to make the people around him laugh. I can't tell you how much I laughed at that yet. He epitomized what it meant to be a family man by teaching me how to be honest to my own wife in the little stuff, by sharing with me how much he actually loved his wife and children, and he epitomized to me what it meant to be a soldier in every sense, from courage to discipline to just honor. He was an honorable man. John was my friend. He was my leader. And I missed it.
Thank you.
For the longest time, I kind of sacrificed him. I couldn't. So I called him Hill. And I was at the academy with him at Rest Home at Huntsville, Alabama. And before you know it, everybody else started calling him Hill. Everybody knew him as Hill. And it was because I couldn't say his name. And he didn't mind it. He was a jokester. He was... Once he came to the room, you knew he was there. There was no denying it. There was no hiding it. Either with this bald head like mine, or his sense of humor, his crazy dance that he had, only he could have. But he was the leader. Oh man, he was such a leader. He was such a motivator. He would pull stuff out of you that you didn't know you had in you. He made you a better person, a better soldier, a better human being. He was one of the most stubbornest men I've ever known in my life. Did you tell him to not do something? He would do it just to, like, you can't do this. Why not? Because you just can't. And you're not a good enough reason. So he would do it. The passion he had for soldiers. If you could have seen him, and he would just talk about his soldiers, and how he would talk about his family, but how he would inspire him. He wasn't a spotlight. A lot of people in the army, you know, you see they there for them. He was just the opposite. He would, when he came to me, I was on my last leg. I was about to get out of the army. I was done with the army. I felt drained. He got there and he motivated me, inspired me with his own way of telling me all a piece of crap, but anyway. but not, he built you down, but he tear you down and he built you right back up. He was just so good. He was an amazing man, amazing friend. In the Army, you meet a lot of people. And a lot of people are friends, associates, but when you move on, you lose that friendship. Sort of, but with me and Ella, we just—it was different. It was different. There was a bond there, some kind of a romance. He was awesome. I love the guy. He's my mentor. He's my friend. This is incredible.
Thank you. I'm just going to kind of wing it. I didn't write anything down. Hopefully, I can keep it together. It's going to take a few minutes. It's great to let the people who've worked with them talk about them first. Obviously, after high school, our lives took different directions, but we always stayed in contact pretty frequently. I remember they texted me and having them text their draft pick in the NFL because he's on the field and didn't have a chance to follow it pick by pick, so I do stuff like that for them now. I love the guy. Over the years, we fought for each other. He loved to laugh, he loved life. He was like a brother to me. He's gonna be missed. I know this is part of life, death. And if we have any sort of immortality, it's having kids to carry on your name, carry on your legacy, and I'm glad he had that. He's a great man. I'm gonna love him, I'm gonna miss him. And I hate seeing him in a box right now. I think it's way before his time. Things happen for a reason, they say. I guess this is how it was supposed to be. But I'm going to miss you, brother. He loved his family. He loved his country. And he loved the Army. And he showed that by serving all those years. He did something that I wasn't allowed to do because of a medical condition. And I salute him for that. He'll always be remembered in my heart, along with my sister Danielle and her family. Goodbye, Jen. I hope to see you someday when I'm knocking on heaven's door.
As sons and daughters of his peace, the stewards of these mysteries, let no fear rob you of worth. His love has overcome the earth. Oh, his love has overcome the earth. Breathe in.
and the unfailing Father.
I'd like to begin with these words. God of us all, your love never ends. When all else fails, you still are God. We pray to you for one another in our need, and for all anywhere who mourn this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. To all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. In all our ways we trust you. And to you, with your church on earth and in heaven, we offer glory and honor now and forevermore. Amen. May we pray. O God, you've ordered this wonderful world and know all things in earth and in heaven. Give us such faith that by day and by night, at all times and in all places, we may, without fear, ourselves and those dear to us to your never falling and failing love in this life and in the life to come. Amen.
Thank you.
present this flag to you on behalf of the President of the United States, the United States Army, and a grateful nation. Please accept this flag as a token of appreciation for the loved ones' honorable and faithful service.
Thank you. Country Guard riders have been very honored to stand in support of the family these past 3 days and in honor of the first sergeant. On behalf of a grateful America and the Patriot Guard riders, for bravely and proudly carrying the burden of defending this country, for service to this nation and the sacrifices made, we sincerely thank you. First Sergeant John L. Locicero, United States Army, 1996 to 2015, Ammunition Specialist, Chief Ammunition NCO, Kuwait, Germany, Iraq, Korea, Bronze Star, Iraqi Campaign Medal, Iraqi Defense Medal, Korean Defense Medal, Army Commendation Medals, multiple, Army Valorous Unit Awards, 5, Global War on Terrorism Medal, Samuel L. Sharpe Award, Military Volunteer Service Medal, Army Combative Level 4, U.S. Army Pathfinder Badge. The First Sergeant is a true American hero.
Her
free like the wind.